Hello everyone. In this very video, we want to see the answers solution to the tutorial questions. The first one says determine the angular speed of a 45 kilogram wheel. Radius of gyration is 0.5 when acted upon by a 1 kilowatt motor for a period of 4 seconds. Okay. First of all, we can see that the mass is 45 kilogram. Let me clean that up. So we have 45 kilogram, okay? Radius of gyration, which is K, is equal to 0.5. Okay, and the power is 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt actually means 1,000 watts. Then the time given is 4 seconds, okay? Now, from the mass and K, we can find the value for I. I, that's the moment of inertia. Moment of inertia is mk squared. That means mass times the square of the radius of gyration. Okay, which means 45 times 0.5 squared, and that gives us 11.25 kilogram meter square. Okay, now K is in meters. Okay, so, but we know that power times time, that means work done is equal to the rotational kinetic energy, which is half I omega squared. And we are looking for omega. So we can make that substitution. We can make omega the subject of formula. We're going to have omega now to be equal to square root, okay, of 2 times power times time, okay, divided by I, which is the moment of inertia. And if we substitute the values, let's quickly do that. Let's say we have 2 times the power is 1,000. Okay, the time is 4 seconds divided by the moment of inertia we got to be 11.25. If you calculate this, you're going to see that your final answer is 26.7. So that's the answer, radians per seconds. That's the unit, 26.7. So you should know that the work done is always, that the work done in rotation, which is power times time, is equal to the rotational kinetic energy, which is half I omega squared. Okay, so note that. Now we see the second question here. It says calculate the work in 90 revolutions by a force of 20 newtons acting tangentially at a rim of a wheel radius 20 centimeter. Okay, first of all, the number of revolutions we have here is 90. Okay, so 90 revolutions, and the force we are given here is 20 newtons. Now, please note that let me make this clear. The number of revolution, the symbol is small n, then the radius is 20 centimeter, which means 0.2 meters. Okay, so we are asked to find the work done. What is work done? Work done is actually torque times angular distance. Remember that the linear analog of work is force times distance. So the angular analog of force is torque, and the angular analog of distance is angular distance. Don't forget that. So the issue now is how do we get torque and angular distance? Our torque is simply force times radius. I did that in previous videos. Okay, the force is 20, the radius is 0.2. Okay, so that gives us 4. So 4 Newton meters. Now, the next is this, which is the angular distance. Angular distance is actually 2 pi times the number of revolutions. Angular distance is 2 pi times the number of revolutions. Okay, so that's going to give us 2 pi times 90. And 2 pi times 90 is 180. So the answer there is 180 pi radians. Okay, so finally, what we are actually asked to find is the work. We say work is the torque times the angular distance. So the torque is 4, so that is work. The torque is 4, the angular distance is 180 pi. So what do we get there? 720 pi joules. That's the answer to that question. That's quite easy. Okay, so the next is this. It says a 36 kilogram wheel, radius of gyration 25 centimeter, is to be given a speed of 10 revolutions per second in 25 revolutions from rest. Find the constant unbalanced torque required. We are looking for torque still here, but let's see what we are given. We are given mass to be 36 kilogram, the mass of the wheel, We are given radius of gyration, which is K, to be 25 centimeter. 25 centimeter, let me do this. 25 centimeter actually means 0.25 meters, okay? And the speed is 10 revolutions per second. So that's frequency. Revolution per second is talking about frequency, which is 10 revolutions per second, okay? Then the number of revolutions n is equal to 25 revolutions. Okay, so let's see. But what formula can we use here? There are two formulas we know from balanced torque. One of them is that it is moment of inertia times angular acceleration, or we can say force times radius. So the best formula I can see that we can use here is this, moment of inertia times angular acceleration. We can find moment of inertia, and we can also find angular acceleration given what we have. So let's go straight to point. Now we see that the moment of inertia is mk squared. That means mass times the square of the radius of gyration. The mass is 36, okay? This is 0.25 n squared, okay? And if we do that, that is going to give us 2.25 kilogram meter squared, okay? So the next is to find the angular acceleration. How do we find angular acceleration? Let's find angular velocity first of all, which is 10 which is 2 pi f. That means 2 pi times 10. That gives us 20 pi, okay? So your angular velocity is 20 pi. Then we can find angular distance since we are given number of revolution, which is 2 pi times n, okay? That means 2 pi times 25, and that's going to give us 50 pi radians, okay? Now, according to the equation of motion, one of the equation of motion is that omega squared is equal to omega naught squared plus 2 alpha theta, if you can remember that. Let me rub this side off. Wow, this is really getting interesting. Okay, so we say, but if you notice, the question says from rest, so meaning that omega naught is zero. So we are going to see omega squared is equal to 2 alpha theta. So we can find alpha, which is omega squared divided by 2 theta. So my omega is 20, so that means 20 pi all squared divided by 2 times 50 pi, okay? And if we divide that, we are going to get 4 pi, okay? So that means my angular acceleration is simply 4 pi. So I can find my torque. Remember, we said that torque is moment of inertia times angular acceleration. My moment of inertia, we got to be 2.25. Okay, but the torque is 4 pi, okay? The angular acceleration, sorry. So 2.25 times 4 pi will give us our final answer, which is 9. So the answer is 9 pi Newton meters. Newton meters is the unit for torque. This is interesting. Okay, so let us see the next question. Here it says, a 10 kilogram wheel rolls on a horizontal surface at a rate of 4 meter per second. Compute its total kinetic energy in joules, okay? Assuming the mass is concentrated at the rim. Okay, so we are given mass here to be 10 kilograms. And we are also told, given the velocity, which is 4 meter per second, which is the linear velocity, okay? Now we ask to calculate the total kinetic energy. Remember, there are two motions involved here. It's not just rotational motion, because the question says a 10 kilogram wheel rolls on a horizontal surface. Rolls on the horizontal surface. So two motions are involved here. That means rotational motion and translational motion. So that means the total kinetic energy is equal to rotational kinetic energy, okay, plus the translational kinetic energy. Let me call that trans, okay? Kinetic energy. So the rotational kinetic energy we know is half I omega squared, okay? Plus the translational kinetic energy, as we know, is half mv squared, okay? So what do we do here? But if you notice, we're only giving two values, which is mass and velocity. It's still very easy to deal with. Your moment of inertia, I, is simply mr squared, if you can remember. That's the formula for moment of inertia of a rigid body, mr squared. Now, your omega here can be written as v over r. Since we know that omega is v over r, so v over r all squared, then we have our half mv squared here. Now, if we continue that, this is going to be half, okay, mr squared times v squared over r squared. V over r all squared means v squared over r squared, then plus half mv squared. Okay, so r squared cancels r squared. So you are now left with half mv squared, okay, for here, then plus half mv squared. And half mv squared plus half mv squared is simply mv squared. This is beautiful. So the whole of this now has been reduced to just mv squared. Okay, so let's substitute values. What is mv squared? Your m there is 10, which is the mass. Your v is 4, the velocity, 4 squared. So that's going to be 10 times 16. And 10 times 16 is 160 joules. Thank you very much. I will see you in my next video. Don't forget to click the subscribe button, you know, to get more of my updates. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.